वेलकम एवरीवन। वी आर डिस्कसिंग रिलेशन, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रिलेशंस। सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन टू क्लासेस ऑन बेसिक पार्ट ऑफ रिलेशन, बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट। टुडे थ्रू दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन। इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन, we know, we have already discussed what is symmetric relation, what is reflexive relation, what is tangential relation. So a symmetric, reflexive and tangential relation is called equivalence relation. Symmetric AB belongs to R, the reverse one, BA belongs to R, then R is called symmetric. Reflexive, same order here, AA belongs to R, then R is reflexive. And tangential, you know, AB, BC belongs to R, implies AC belongs to R, then R is tangential. We have already discussed it. So it is tangential relation. For example, L1 parallel to L2, L2 parallel to L3. So L1 parallel L3. So relation parallel to is tangential. So a symmetric, reflexive and tangential relation is called equivalence. In short, it is SRT, symmetric, reflexive, tangential. Now, I consider a very, very simple one. So, A equals to 1, 2, 3. Now, the relation R1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2. Whether R1 is equivalence or not. So look, for reflexive, A equals to 1, 2, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 2 belongs to it. But 3, 3, 3, 3 does not belong to R. So 3, 3 is not included in R1. So R1 is not reflexive. If any one of the condition is not satisfied, then it is not equivalence. So R1 is not equivalence relation. So this is very, very simple. If set A is given, then problem will be very, very simple. Now we consider R3. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3. Whether R3 is equivalence or not. Now look, A equals to 1, 2, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 2. Same order here belongs to R3. So R3 is reflexive. Now symmetric. If AB belongs to R, BA should belong to R. So look, so reverse, if we reverse 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, no change. Now 1, 2 belongs to R, implies 2, 1 belongs to R. Now 2, 3 belongs to R, implies 3, 2 belongs to R. R means here R3. So R3 is symmetric. R3 is symmetric. This is very, very simple one. Now, tangential, you look, one, two, so if we take 1, 2, then you have to take order pair which starts with 2, 1, 2, 2, 3. belongs to R. If we combine it, then we are getting 1-3. 1-3 is not present here, so does not belong to R. So, if for one element, one order pair, it is not satisfied, then it is not transitive. So R3 is not transitive. So look, if we take 1-1 and 1-2, so we are getting 1-2. 1-2 belongs to R. You can say that it is reflexive. You have to verify for all order pairs. But if you disprove for at the beginning for any two order pairs, suppose 1-2 and 2-3, 1-2 and 2-3 belongs to R3, but 1-3 does not belong to R3. So R3 is not transitive. To disprove it, example is sufficient. So R3 is not transitive. So it is not symmetric. R3 is not symmetric. Sorry. Equivalence. Now, problem number 2, subpart 2. So look, 1-1, 2-2, 3-3. So same order pair, A belongs to R. So R2 is reflexive. Now symmetricity, 1-2 belongs to R, 2 implies 2-1 belongs to R. So 2-1, so R2 is symmetric. Now 1-1 and starting with 1-2 belongs to R implies 1-2 belongs to R. So now 1-1, so 2-2, then starting with 2-1 belongs to R implies 2-1 belongs to R. R means R. Now 2-2, 2-2, 2-3 belongs to R implies 2-3 belongs to R2. Then 3-3. So 3-3 and starting with 3, we are getting only 1. So 3-2 belongs to R2. R2 implies 3-2 belongs to R2. So it is verified for all the order pair. So R2 is tangitive. So we have already proved it is reflexive, it is symmetric, and it is proved that it is tangitive. So R2 is equivalence relation. So if set A is given, then it is very simple to verify. But for general set, set of integers, set of real numbers, so you have to use general method. Now we are discussing it, taking some problems. Now I consider three similar like problems. Prove that relation R means relation, R equals to relation. On Z, set of integer, R equals to AB, A minus B is divisible by N, is an equivalence relation. Prove that R on Z, A minus B is divisible by N, N is positive integer, is an equivalence relation. Prove that R on J, R equals to AB, A plus B given, is an equivalence relation. There are same type, and most important for board exam. So we consider the general one. R equals to AB. A minus B is divisible by N. So it is equivalence. We have to prove. So for reflexive. So you know AA belongs to R. Implies. What is the rule? Difference of number. Same order we are taking for reflexive. So A minus A equals to 0. 0 is divisible by any integer. Because 0 by any number is 0. So divisible by n. Therefore R is reflexive. For reflexive we always take two numbers x and y as same, because AA belongs to R. Now symmetry. So AB belongs to R implies A minus B is divisible by M. So this implies B minus A is also divisible by M. If here quotient is 1, then if it is B minus A minus 1, so A minus B is divisible by N, B minus A is also divisible by N. We know, therefore AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. So R is symmetric. So if it is 2, obvious, so it is N is replaced by 2. So this is most general one. Now for transitive. We have to take two orders here, AB, and second one is B at first. BC belongs to R, implies A minus B is divisible by N. So A minus B equals to K1N, where K1 belongs to Z. BC belongs to R implies B minus C is divisible by N. Look at the step. This transitive, you have to note this one. So B minus C equals to K2N divisible by N. So it is multiple of N. So where K2 belongs to Z. Now, transitive property states that we have to get a relation involving A and C. So this is A minus B, 1, this is 2. So we need A minus C. So to get A minus C, add 1 and 2. 1 plus 2 implies. So look, B cancel. A minus C, K1 plus K2 into N. Equals to integer into N. So divisible by N. K1 plus K2 is integer. So finally what we are getting? You look, AB BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. Because A minus C is divisible by N. So R is transitive. So this step to be noted. A minus B K1N, B minus C K2N, add it, A minus C, so is divisible by N. So this is our property. So R is transitive. So what is R? R is SRT relation, hence it is transitive. transitive. So this one is most important problem, and this is general one. Now I consider four similar problem. A equals to set of lines in plane whose the relation R parallel to is an equivalence relation. Relation R perpendicular to is symmetric but not reflexive and tangent. So consider problem number A. Set of all lines in a plane. So L means set of all lines. L1, L2, L3. Yes. So suppose L is a line. L. So every line, we know this assumption, every line is parallel to itself. LL belongs to R. So every line is parallel to itself. This is our assumption, you know. If two lines L coincides, then we say every line is parallel to itself. Therefore, LL belongs to R. So R is reflexive. So every line is parallel to itself. This is L, take a line L on it, that is coincident line. It is satisfied. So you must write this one. Now if we know L1 parallel to L2, then reverse also true. L2 parallel to L1. So in terms of order pair, we can write L1 L2 belongs to R implies L2 L1 belongs to R. So R is symmetric. So L1, this is L1, L2 also parallel to this. This is symmetric. Then transitive. So L1 parallel L2 and L2 parallel L3. L1 parallel L2, L2 parallel L3. So what is the relation between L1 and L3? Implies L1 parallel L3. So this, in terms of order here, L1, L2, L2, L3. Belongs to R implies L1, L3 belongs to R. So R is transitive. So R is SRT relation and hence equivalence relation. So very simple one. Now B, look, perpendicular. In case of parallel, every line is parallel to itself. But listen, for two, every line is not perpendicular to itself. So it is not symmetric. So every line is not perpendicular for B. Is not perpendicular to itself. So L, L does not belong to R. R is not reflexive. Now for symmetry, if L1 parallel L2 perpendicular L2, then L2 perpendicular L1. So L1, L2 belongs to L1. Perpendicular to L2. So reverse also true. L1, L2 belongs to R implies L2, L1 belongs to R. So R is symmetric. So relation R is symmetric but not reflexive, we have already proved. and tangential also. So L1 perpendicular to L2 and L2 perpendicular to L3. L1 perpendicular and L2 perpendicular to L2 perpendicular to L3. So L1 parallel to L3. So implies from our idea of geometry, L1 perpendicular to L2, L2 perpendicular to L2 perpendicular to L3 implies L1 parallel to but not perpendicular to L3. So L1, L2 and L2, L3 belongs to R implies L2, L3 does not belong to R. So R is not tangential. R is not tangential. Not tangential. So this is now C and D exactly same that of 1. Because you know congruent, every triangle is congruent to itself, just like the problem number 1. Every triangle is similar to itself. So you complete C and D. Problem number C and D. Now problem number 3. Let f x to y, x and y are two sets, be a function. Define a relation R on x given by R equals to AB, FA equals to AB. Examine whether R is equivalence or not. So we first go to reflexivity. Reflexivity. Let small a belongs to x. Let small a belongs to x. Implies FA equals to FA. FA equals to FA. So same functional value at same point. So this implies if FA equals to AB, then it is AB. So AA belongs to R. So R is reflexive. Reflexive. FA equals to FA. So FA equals to AB. So this is AB. So FA equals to FA, A belongs to R, R is reflexive. Then triangle symmetricity, symmetric relation. We have to verify whether R is symmetric or not. Let AB belongs to R. So this implies FA equals to AB, while AB belongs to X. AB belongs to X. FA equals to AB implies AB equals to FA, implies BA belongs to R. FA equals to AB, AB belongs to R. So AB equals to BA, we can say BA belongs to R. So R is symmetric. So AB belongs to R. Obviously AB belongs to X. FA equals to AB implies AB equals to FA, BA belongs to R. Then transitive. AB, BC belongs to R implies FA equals to AB and AB equals to FC. So obviously ABC belongs to capital S. So this implies FA equals to FC, implies AC belongs to ABBC belongs to R, implies AC belongs to R. So R is tangential. So R is SRT relation and hence equivalence relation. R is SRT relation, hence it is equivalence relation. These are all Bode's problem. Now I consider one more problem, very simple problem. R is a relation on set of real numbers. R equals to AB mod A minus B is even. AB belongs to R. Prove that R is equivalence relation. So symmetricity, reflexive. So AA belongs to R implies mod A minus A equals to 0 is even. 0 is considered as even number because it is divisible by 2. So R is reflexive. Now symmetry. AB belongs to R implies mod A minus B is even. So we have already considered this problem. Mod B minus A is also even. Because mod of minus 1 is 1 implies BA belongs to R. So R is symmetric. So transitive. So AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R implies mod A minus B is even. That is A minus B mod A minus B is even. That is A minus B equals to plus minus 2M. M belongs to Z. So if we omit mod, we get plus minus. So BC belongs to R implies mod B minus C is even. That is B minus C equals to plus minus 2M. N belongs to Z. This is 1, this is 2. Now you have to prove A minus C is even. So if you add, so BB cancel, A minus C plus minus common M plus N into 2. So this is obviously even. So AC belongs to R. So AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. AB, BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. So R is transitive. So R is SRT relation. R is SRT relation. Hence, it is an equivalence relation. So this is very, very simple problem, but most important for both. So today, through this video, I have discussed some important problem of equivalence relation. In the next class, I will also solve 5 or 6 problems of on equivalence relation for board exam. So, thank you for today.